Let me start with a statement. Human beings have infinite potential, but we see a large degree of difference between one person and another person. Some people are highly effective, others are just normal of the run. What we are trying to learn today or understand, what really makes people effective? Please remember, God created everybody almost equal. Since the topic is effectiveness, where does effectiveness come through? Effectiveness will come through action or work done. You may have a beautiful ideas, but if you don't implement, effectiveness does not come in life. If that is so, let's try to find out how any work is done, small or big. Every work is done in two phases, in two stages. The first creation is in the mind as the thought process. And the second is creation of the actual work, which requires skill and energy. Please remember, the task may be small or a big. It always goes through two stages. First creation in the mind, and second physical implementation of the same. One more area. The first creation in the mind always precedes physical action. It's a very important point to look into. Nothing happens without the first creation in the mind. Example is, suppose you want to build a house. Please remember, you don't start digging foundation or making the walls. You start always as a thought process. Thought process is the mind. That is the first creation. What do you want to create? Is it a two-bedroom house? Is it a small villa or an institution? What do I really want to build? And the second stage is, you know, it is followed by a blueprint. And then actually do the implementation. So first creation is always in the mind. Second, when you really try to implement it. And that requires skills and energy. Both are important. Let's find out the skill sets. Please remember, skills are very important for doing any action. It may be a painting, it may be talking, welding, or learning accounting, management sciences, all those things together. In fact, most of the people sitting in this room, we have spent more than 20 years of life in learning the skills. It's correct also, because without skills, you cannot take any action or do any work. And without any work, you really cannot become very effective. And frankly speaking, skills have been overrated in the society also. I'll come to this point soon. Imagine, I hope you can recognize the picture. It's a Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli is a very popular cricketer. He is on the crease. The question is, he's a very effective player and a very popular player too. Please remember, he does not play only with this bat or a body. The ball is always played in the mind first. Suppose he's on the crease and his mind is somewhere else. He is thinking of Anushka or the next some assignment. He is doing some peer work or something of the sort. Please remember, he has to play every ball. For every ball, there must be a first creation, and his mind has to be in the present moment. That means the incoming ball. It's important. The moment he misses out, please remember, all his footwork, skills in playing different things will be of no use. So that means the mind has to be in the present moment to be really effective. Let's look at the first creation. Please remember, the first creation, as I mentioned, is very important. Because that's what really determines effectiveness. And let's look at quite a few people who are highly effective in life. I have intentionally taken people from different disciplines. People like Bill Gates from IT, or J.R.D. Tata, or Dhirubhai Ambani, or even Sachin Tendulkar. These people are highly effective in the different areas of operation. Now, question is, let's look at their, what makes them really effective. Please remember, if you look at their skill sets, the skill sets between amongst highly effective people and ordinary people, the difference is very large. It's not very large. It is only percentage. I remember I attended Bill Gates' lecture in CII in Bombay a long time ago, and he made a very interesting statement. He said, India has got so many engineers, software engineers, they are highly skilled. And he was very humble, and he also said, some of them are more skilled than him in IT. That's the truth also. But the beauty is, all you put all 76,000 software engineers on one side and put this small boy, Bill Gates, on one side, he is far more effective than others. That means the difference in skill sets is not very large. Let me go to your personal experience. When you graduated, some people might be more skilled than you in your area of operation. They got more marks. They were toppers. Are they really more effective in life? Perhaps not. Let me reverse the situation. The students who got less marks than you, that means they were less skilled as compared to you, are they less effective than you? Answer is again, no. That means the correlation between effectiveness in life and the skills is comparatively very poor. But please remember, everybody is worried about the skills, marks and everything, you know. I want more marks, I want more skills. No doubt skills are important, but that's not an end by itself. Because even the most effective people, their skill sets are normal. Now the question is, where does the difference lie? The difference lies basically in the first creation in the mind. That is very important. That is the fundamentally difference between the highly effective people and the ordinary people. First creation makes a big difference. And frankly speaking, where does the first creation take place? It takes place in the mind as a thought process. And mind has not been a subject of discussion in the whole academic career, neither in the schools, nor colleges, nor IITs, nor IIMs. It is not a subject of discussion at all in the West. In India, of course, people have been talking about the mind to some extent. So let's look at the mind, where the first creation takes place as a thought process. And mind has got options. It goes to the past. All of us think about the past events, maybe good or bad. We also think about the future. Kal kya hoga? That means there's anxiety. Will I get admission? Will I get married to the right girl? Will I get a promotion? Anxiety. But where is the action? Action is primarily in the present moment of time. And please remember, even when the mind is in the present moment, suppose you are emotionally disturbed, you are angry, you are in sorrow, you can't be really effective. So for creative work, you have to live in the present moment and you should be emotionally calm. Please remember, it is very difficult to keep the mind in the present moment. The mind fluctuates. Let me give you a small case study of myself, how the mind really works. I have taken an example of looking at champa tree at the back of my house. I start looking at the tree. I say, champa tree is very beautiful. I remember the way it's shown in the Kangra Valley of Arts. You know, they are very symmetrical leaves, symmetrical flowers. Then I think over, you know, Kangra Valley rivulets are very attractive. Then the mind goes on. But most beautiful river is Ganga. I remember when we had gone with the family in Ganga, my son Mohit would not come out of Ganga. I wonder what Mohit is doing in Munich. He has forgotten his woolen's hair. I must send him an email tonight. 10 minutes are over. My eyes are open, but am I seeing the champa tree? The champa tree was very much there. The question is, you know, champa tree was there, my eyes were there, but mind had gone somewhere else. And mind wanders the world, and we are not in the present moment. That's the fundamental thing, how the mind really works out. Now, this is a case study which of mine. Please remember, case studies are good for learning. We use it in the management systems. But please remember, very few people learn from the case studies. There are thousands of case studies which say smoking is injurious to health. People still smoke. Unko hua, mujhe nahi hoga. So things are different in area. So please remember, I may make a statement, the mind is very difficult to control and live in the present moment. But the truth is, unless you experience yourself, learning cannot take place. Let's take a small experiment now. I want you to experience your own mind. How does it really work? I want you to sit comfortably, feet on the ground, sit straight, hands in a comfortable position. Because unless you experience it, the lecture is of no use. Now what I want to do is, there's no champatri here. I want you to have a look at the national flag. And all of you know the national flag, all the colors and everything. I want you to see the national flag with good colors, stationary, and sharp colors. And for 15 seconds only. And please remember, when you see the national flag with your eyes closed, how do you see it? Eyes cannot see it. You see it as the thought process in the mind, first creation. The time starts now. Let's take about 15 seconds and try to see the national flag. Thank you. Please open your eyes. I will not ask individually, but I've done this exercise 1,000 times with the students and many other people also. You know the difficulty. Many of you could not have been even able to see the national flag. Leave aside a stationary flag. I will not discuss it, but you know very well how it is. These conditions are ideal. That means your eyes are closed. There are least disturbances. But even then, to keep the mind on a desired item is very difficult. But there's nothing wrong with you. That's the way the mind really works. And it's very difficult to keep the mind in the present moment. Now, I made an opening statement that human beings have got infinite potential. This is applicable not only to Bill Gates or Dhirubhai Ambani, it's applicable to all of us. Now, the question is, how is the effectiveness lost? Imagine, you know, the square indicates my potential. Though the potential is infinite, but I make it finite to understand. This is the potential of everybody. The potential gets reduced due to various factors. The first factor is, past worries. We spend a huge amount of time what happened in the past. We are worried about that. Sometimes good events also, but mostly worries. So my potential gets reduced to that extent. Next, potential reduced due to anxieties for the future. What will happen tomorrow? So the white portion gets reduced still further. Thirdly, effectiveness gets reduced due to social or the emotional disturbances. It can be anger, it can be depression, it can be anything. And lastly, the potential is reduced further due to undirected activities. Undirected activities means we are doing something X and we are thinking of Y. People are in office, they are still thinking about the home. You start with the project A, you are thinking of B, C and D. That means the task at hand is not done in a very effective fashion. This sums the whole picture of all the four together. Past worries, future anxieties, emotional disturbance and undirected activities. Please remember, they are dynamic in nature. Different time, different things will happen. But the truth is, how small is the portion which is really effective? Highly effective people are able to push back the past worries, future anxieties, undirected activities, and they are able to live in the present moment. So even with the normal skills, they are able to do far more as compared to the highly skilled people. Earlier diagram was not to the scale. Now you see, the potential is very large. We make use of very small quantity. And let me now tell you the difference between highly effective people and the ordinary people. If you look at the left side, that is what is the ordinary human being. Potential is very big, but we are only able to make use of very small quantity of it. Whereas on the right hand, you see highly effective people. They are pushed back the past worries. They are pushed back the future anxieties. And they are more focused on what they are doing. That is what explains even people with a low skill level, they outsmart many other people with a highly skilled one. Meditation, now the question arises, you know, what do you do? How do you solve the problem? How do you become more effective? The West, frankly speaking, has got no solution to that area. The solution lies in the Eastern system of thinking of meditation. And meditation is a structured technique to keep the mind in the present moment where the action lies. Please remember, if done on a regular basis, ordinary people can become extraordinary. I have seen it in my own life. The students who have been doing meditation on a regular basis, their skills were normal, but they are far more effective as compared to others over a period of time. There are many methods of meditation. All of them are good, provided you choose the right one which you want to do it. Now I come to the anticlimax of the whole talk. Bill Gates never did meditation. Neither J.R.D. Tata. Now the question is, what made these people highly effective in life? That needs the real examination. In that case, you know, you can enhance your effectiveness through various other techniques also, which almost have an effect of a meditation. That means you are fully focused on the activity and you learn to live in the present moment. Let's look at first the self-discipline. Some people inherently are highly background to any other reason. The mind will always have a tendency to go here and there. They are able to bring it back. The mind goes away, bring it back. It is self-discipline. They are much more effective. The second category is, you know, keen interest. Please remember, the moment you have a keen interest in any topic or any subject that you're doing, your mind is fully focused. Do you think of the past? No. Do you think of the future? No. That means your mind is mostly in the present moment. So highly effective people are always engaged in activity where they have a keen interest. It's an important factor. You choose, take anyone. Take effective people in any area. They are always operating in an area where they have a keen interest. Third is the challenge. Please remember, if I ask somebody to play against somebody, let's say a game of tennis, if the opponent is not a good player, that hardly gives me any challenge. If I'm forced to play, I'll get bored. Please remember, when the opponent is good, in that case, I start liking it. But when the opponent is giving me a real good challenge, please remember, that is where something great happens. When you are playing against somebody who is better than you, question is, where is your mind? You don't think of the lunch or the dinner. Your mind is on the game. That means you are living in the present moment. This is nothing but a game, a meditation. It leads to meditation. Please remember the earlier factor I talked about, even the keen interest. Interest may be any area. It can be gardening, it can be anything or a painting. The moment you are doing it, you are fully involved in that. You don't think of anything else. It amounts to meditation. Then we have other things, primarily like the concentrate on one activity at a time. I will not dwell on this. The next one is the perseverance. Please remember, nobody becomes an overnight success in any area. Area may be any. It can be music, it can be art, it can be technology. People spend a huge amount of time till they become highly effective in an area. Let's take the case of Beatles. Beatles were a phenomenon in the music at one time. You might think they became very popular overnight. No. These people had played more than 10,000 hours in their life till they were recognized as a group, as a Beatle, and they became highly effective in the world over. Let's take even the case of a Bill Gates, a young boy. Please remember, at that time, those were the days of the big IBM mainframe computers. And coding was very important. I remember when I was in IIT, the best people had not put in more than 500 hours of coding at the time. So people don't become just like that. Perseverance is very important. And many people have talked about the working for 1,000 hours. And that's what makes people really effective. Though these 5-6 factors look different, but if you look at deep, they are all the same. That means they are complementing each other, supplementing each other. If you have a keen interest, you've got a good mental mind, and you are able to face the challenges, that's when you will do perseverance. All the things together make you highly effective. That means when you are engaged in an activity, you get into flow. Flow means you are fully engrossed in that activity only. You don't think of the past, don't think of the future. You live in the present moment where the action is. Highly effective people are in flow. They are fully engaged in an activity, whatever they are doing. And that's what makes them highly effective, irrespective of the skill level they have. Let's go back once again. Dhirubhai Ambani is not a highly skilled person. Most of the employees in his organization would be more skilled as compared to him. It may be marketing, finance, technology. But the truth is, none of them are as effective as a single mind Dhirubhai Ambani. And that comes through the first creation in the mind. Skills are important because the students are sitting here. Skills are important, but that is not the most important thing. First creation in the mind is very important. Mind has to be cultivated. And the most structured technique to keep the mind in the present moment is meditation. And highly effective companies are introducing meditation again and again. Thank you very much.